Welcome guys back to another Wayne Eyes Photos video where we talk about everything road cycling. And if that's your cup of tea, then please consider subscribing and ringing that bell so you don't miss any more of my videos. Well, today we're going to be talking about a bike release from one of the oldest manufacturers in the world, Bianchi, or Biani. I'm not too sure how you pronounce it, but I'm sure there's a few guys down below who will correct the pronunciation. Cheers for that, guys. Well, anyway, the bike we're going to be talking about today is a Specialisma, and Bianchi are actually just rolling out all of the new paint jobs for this new bike, and I must admit they're looking quite impressive, and I quite like some of the fading where they have the Celeste into the black. It looks really quite good. But the real question is this like the old Specialisma, and is it the same bike under the hood? Well, we're going to have a discussion about that after we roll that intro. Well, the old Specialisma was marketed as a lightweight climbing bike, and it was very, very traditionalist design, and I really actually liked it. I actually tried to actually get one second hand, but in Australia, they were actually a special order, and there was very, very few around, and I didn't have much luck. But anyway, you know, I ended up with a Look 695 from Hambini's recommendation, so that bike I'm really enjoying, so I'm glad it went that way. But back to the Specialisma. Now, the new one, the first thing you notice straight away is that it has disc brakes. Now, to me, this is not really an ultimate lightweight climbing bike, because as soon as you put disc brakes on, then you actually have a heavier wheel set. And yes, you might be able to get some weight out of the frame and get the weight of the bike down, but the rigidity has to be compromised, and you've actually got heavier wheels, which means there's more rotating mass potentially, or more weight in the wheels. So to me, this was a little bit disappointing that they're not actually selling alongside a rim brake bike. Anyway, so let's move on. And then if we like look at the bike even further, we find that it's more becoming an XR4. And, you know, this to me is going a little bit the wrong way, because yeah, you might say that's a more popular bike, and it has been. The Ultra XR4 is a beautiful bike. But, you know, do you really want to have something that's the same? You know, aren't you going to pinch, you know, market from that design? Why not put out a different bike that's probably following in, you know, the realm of what the old one was, a more traditional frame that hasn't got dropped seat stays and aero parts on it and disc brakes, and just upgrade the bike to a newer design that is very traditional. Well, one thing I do like about the way Bianchi have brought out the Specialisma is that they have kept the tubes straight on all of the triangles, and I actually really like this look. Even though my two bikes do have curved tubes on them, if I was going by pure aesthetics, I like that traditional look of the straight tubes, you know, like on the old Specialisma, and I really like the look of that bike, and I really like that really chunky down tube it had on it. I think that they're actually going a little bit the wrong way here, because even if you say, yeah, you like the look of the new bike and you like all round the bikes, that's great, but let's really face it, that's what the Ultra XR4 is, and that's probably could be due for an upgrade probably within the next 12 months. So why are you making another bike to compete with a similar bike in your range? You know, why not have something different that may appeal to a different type of rider? And this is where I think Bianchi may be taking away some of their sales from the Ultra XR4 with the Specialisma. Instead of, you know, someone going, oh, look, I want an all-round semi-aero performance bike, and I'll get the Ultra XR4, which that's what it's been, and it's an excellent bike. Now, you go to the Specialisma, which was considered a very traditional lightweight climbing bike. Well, now it's kind of moved into the same space as the Ultra XR4. So I think Bianchi might be actually pinching some of their sales there. But I would have liked to have seen it staying in that realm and you know, at least marketing still the disc brake bikes for the traditionalists on that bike. And I have read that you can get them special order, get the frame special order, But I don't know if that's confirmed. But as far as I'm aware, that it's a disc brake bike, which is really doesn't appeal to me that much. I would rather go and buy an older bike and build it up rather than, you know, find one of the older Specialismas and, you know, put some nice wheels on it and keep it rim brake. That's personally me, but I know a lot of people do like the new disc brake bikes, and yes, they're good, especially if you're in part of the world where you get a lot of variance in weather. Disc brakes are much, much better. But anyway, you guys tell me, what do you think? Do you think Bianchi is going the right way here with this Specialisma? Or do you think that they've upset a lot of people, you know, moving it away from this kind of very traditional type of bike that had something about it, you know, that was a little bit different to, you know, most of the bikes that are on the market? Well, anyway, I'm going to leave it there, guys, and thanks for watching, and let me know what your thoughts are on the way that these designs are going. Cheers for watching. Bye.